Biodiversity offsets are measurable conservation outcomes that are designed to compensate for unavoidable negative biodiversity impacts of projects. Biodiversity offsets are only appropriate for projects which have properly applied the so-called mitigation hierarchy framework. The mitigation hierarchy includes four consecutive steps. The first step is avoidance. Avoiding negative biodiversity effects is almost always easier than fixing the damages. The second step is mitigation or minimizing. It means that after you decide to pursue an action with negative biodiversity impacts, you should try your best to minimize the damages. Again, this is easier than fixing them. The third step is ecological restoration. This is especially relevant in activities that cause temporary effects. For example, an open mine will be abandoned at some point. Restoring the area to natural condition after the use helps to reduce the long-term biodiversity impacts, although it doesn't help during the use of the mine. The last step of the mitigation hierarchy is biodiversity offsetting. It means conservation actions that are conducted outside the area where negative effects take place. The aim of the offsets is to achieve the so-called no net loss state of biodiversity, and preferably a net gain of biodiversity, which means a better state than before the negative actions. Measures that are not designed to result in no net loss or net gain state are not biodiversity offsets and should not be called offsetting. The achievement of the no net loss state happens via measurable, appropriately implemented, monitored, evaluated, and enforced offset schemes. There are two main types of offsetting schemes: the avoided loss offsets and restoration offsets. The avoided loss offsets are situations where areas or values with a documented threat are protected against the threat. For example, a forest with a threat of deforestation or commercial logging is protected. Restoration offsets are situations where degraded areas are restored to better ecological conditions. For example, removing a dam to restore free waterway and to enable fish migration could be a restoration offset. The no net loss state of biodiversity is easier to reach via restoration than avoided loss offsets, because the restoration actions increase the ecological conditions. The effect of the avoided loss offsets is based on the idea that without the actions, the condition would continue decreasing. This so-called baseline of decline is always based on assumptions which must be critically evaluated. Biodiversity offsetting is a complex process that includes several steps with critical decisions and quantitative analysis. For example, the so-called time discounting must be conducted. This means evaluating the time lag between the negative actions and the time point where the target state of the positive actions is reached. If there is a time lag, offsets must always be larger than the actual loss to reach the no net loss state over time. This must be done because the ecological condition is temporarily lower than before the loss. Another important critical decision is defining the biodiversity features that are used in calculating the loss and the offset. The more detailed the features are, the more difficult it is to reach the no net loss state, but also the more reliable the system is. If we, for example, poorly measure the condition of the lost habitat, we may end up estimating the no net loss state to be reached, although part of the lost values are not offset. There are more than 10 additional operational decisions or calculations that must be done as a part of biodiversity offsetting process. To summarize, biodiversity offsetting is the last step of the conservation mitigation hierarchy. It must be based on accurate measurement of properly defined biodiversity features. A project that does not reach no net loss state is not biodiversity offsetting.